Welcome to this talk about HDR videos. It is about the question, what are HDR videos and how to make them with any camera? So the second part will be more like a tutorial. Let's have a look at the outline. We will first define what is dynamic range. Then we will look at standard dynamic range videos. On the one hand, how are they displayed on the screen, and on the second, how a camera records them. Knowing these basics, we will continue with high dynamic range video displayed on the screen and what is special about it. After that, I will show you how to produce HDR video for YouTube using only free software and a consumer camera. What is dynamic range? In photography, the dynamic range is the difference between the darkest and lightest tones in an image. Generally, pure black and pure white. It's more often used to talk about the maximum dynamic range a camera is capable of. So, there are two things: the dynamic range of a scene in reality and the dynamic range a camera is able to capture. The dynamic range of the scenery is defined by the distance between the bright parts of the sky and the dark parts of the trees. You can see that the sky is partly overexposed, so the camera was not able to capture the whole dynamic range of the scene. Before I continue, I would like to introduce histograms shortly. You can see one over here. On the x-axis, brightness values are listed a pixel can have. Dark pixels on the left and bright ones on the right. You can see on this histogram that there are many dark pixels in this image, a few bright ones on the right and nearly no medium gray pixels in between. So, how is standard dynamic range video displayed? I choose here my mobile phone's screen as an example because an OLED screen is capable of displaying standard and high dynamic range video. For displaying standard video, the user is capable of setting a screen brightness. In this case, the phone's automatic brightness function chooses a value that fits well to the environment. The background has similar brightness compared to the screen. The bright pixels of a video that is displayed on this screen can become as bright as the brightness setting allows it. In this case, the dynamic range of this screen is not used completely. It would be able to display the bright pixels brighter if one would increase the brightness setting. So, in general, we consider the dynamic range a standard dynamic range video is displayed with as a lot smaller than some scenes in reality. Wherefore, we need dynamic compression. I will show you on the next slide how it is made. How does a consumer camera record video? For the pros that already know about log gamma, I mean a camera that does not use log gamma. On the top, you can see a histogram that shall display the brightness derivation on our scene in reality. Imagine a camera would be capable of capturing the whole dynamic range of the scene. If it would be displayed on a standard dynamic range display, the contrast would look very soft. In most cases, the relevant part of a picture is the one that is in the medium bright region. Without dynamic compression, the display would use only, let's say, 66% of its dynamic range to display the important content. The contrast would look very soft and unreal. To compensate, cameras do dynamic compression at the borders. You can see here that the bright region was compressed. The blue peak is narrower and closer to the border. Now, the important medium bright region of the image is displayed with more dynamic range. The dynamic range is now more similar to the real dynamic range the region has in reality. How much this compression happens is determined by the gamma curve setting in the camera. Now to the high dynamic range video on a display. You can see the brightness setting is disabled while the phone displays HDR content. The screen operates at full brightness level. In this case, the screen is much brighter than the book in the background. Video is now displayed with a full dynamic range the screen can achieve. Because the displayed dynamic range is now larger, the dynamic compression for HDR videos can compress a lot less or maybe don't compress at all, depending on the recorded scene. This is why HDR videos look so cool and more real. Now to the tutorial part. How do we make HDR videos for YouTube? During this process, we have to undo the dynamic compression of the camera. I figured out how to do this using only three software: DaVinci Resolve and MKV Merge. I do have a paid version of DaVinci Resolve, but you will be able to follow along 100% with a free version because I will not use any of the paid features. Okay, I would like to show you how do I edit my HDR videos. What is my workflow to produce HDR video for YouTube? Here I have a sample clip. It's some recording from a forest. And the first thing I do is to edit it like normal video. I can add text, I can add music, I can add color correction, for example. And I do this at first like I like it on the screen. So I don't have HDR in mind now. Okay. I think this might be enough. So, now imagine you have finished your clip with many videos and transitions and sound and speech and text and whatever you want. Create a new timeline and drag in your clip. Go to the color page and now we have to undo the dynamic range compression. I apply a gamma curve, I think about like this and like this. So I do use the second line from the top and go two squares from the right and one to the top. And I choose the last line and I go one square down and two from the side. This is my default gamma curve to convert a video to HDR. You can see the effect by adding another corrector node. And you can see that the brightness values here that are compressed become uncompressed. The peak is not as high as without this gamma curve. So this is the gamma curve I apply at default to undo the dynamic compression. Of course, it's not the perfect gamma curve for every video. You can try around. For example, I usually upload maybe 10 seconds to YouTube, private on my channel, wait until the HDR processing happened, and test it on my mobile phone, how it looks, and if I like it, I publish it with a full clip, and if I don't like it, I adjust the settings. For example, if the bright things are not bright enough, here you can see that after the gamma correction, the very bright values aren't used at all. So what you can do, you can slide to the left with this point and define the brightest value here. Everything gets brighter, and if this helps for the HDR video, you can do it. Okay, this is all about the brightness values, but there's one more thing you have to do. You have to lower the saturation. In my experience, 32 is a great value. It does not have effect on this image because it is by nature very low saturated, but if a video is recognized as HDR, the saturation is much higher compared to what you see on the screen now. Okay, so let's deliver it and upload it to YouTube. First, I have to render it in a format that YouTube accepts for HDR videos. Unfortunately, the two formats I figured out produce very large files, so the upload is slow, but at least it works. So QuickTime is okay, but we need this codec and a 10-bit file. But this works as okay. This is the recommended option by me. YouTube accepts it and it produces smaller files compared to the other possible options. Audio is okay. The location. Okay, here is our rendered file. Now we have to use MKV merge. So what is MKV merge? YouTube has an information page about how to upload HDR videos and what a video needs to be recognized as HDR video is HDR metadata. So some information in the file that says, okay, this is an HDR video. And to add this information to a file, there's this page, and on this page they describe how to do this with the mkvmerge.exe file. I've downloaded it already, so here is it. And I have a command figured out that works best for me. Here's the default command, but my command looks like this. So my file is named test, and the interesting setting is this one. Here you can define that the maximum brightness value the video reaches is 1000 nits. And here's the name of the output file. So let's do it. So it just copies the file. So it is very fast, it does not render it, it just copies the file and adds some HDR metadata. And here is the file you can upload to YouTube. You have noticed that the file is really large for the maybe 10 seconds of video, but I haven't figured out how to produce small files for YouTube. The other way I figured out was to render MP4 and convert it to Apple ProRes, what produces also large files, is a bit smaller, but I noticed that using DNxHR the quality on YouTube is much better. So in theory it should be possible to upload 10-bit MP4, but in my tests YouTube does not recognize it. So this file you can upload to YouTube and it will be recognized as HDR video. And I recommend trying a few iterations of uploading, watching on the phone, changing the color settings and upload again. So thanks for watching, that's all for now. If you have figured out how to use 10-bit MP4 files, or if you have a question, please let me know in the comments. Also, you can show me your beautiful HDR videos by posting a link.